Hello everyone, I am Muhtar, machine learning, vision, line detection with Hough Transform. Import necessary Python libraries. Step 1, open an input image. Open an image and convert it to an array. Note that the input image should be a resultant image of an edge detection filter. For example, Kenny or any other similar edge detection algorithms. In this tutorial, the background and object have been set to black and white, respectively, in the input image. First, open image. The image name is test002.png. Convert to grayscale. Get size. Before I move to the next step, the main idea of the Hough Transform will be presented by using this picture. Then we will return to the code again. Detecting lines with Hough Transform. This picture shows the main idea of Hough Transform. This is XY Cartesian coordinate. We call it XY image space, since we are going to apply this coordinate to an input image. As we know, this is the equation of a line in this coordinate system, where K and B represent the slope and the intercept, respectively. P1 and P2 represent two points on the same line L. In normal situation, for each line in this coordinate system, we have to have a slope k and an intercept b. So here, for a specific line, k and b are constant parameters. X and y are the variables. In contrast, if we try to find the possible solution for k or b in the line equation, in other words, if we set and assume that X and Y are the constant parameters, K and B are considered as the variables, then we got the solutions for given points P1 and P2. As for point P1, we got this expression. For point 2, we got this expression. Actually, this is another type of equation for a line, where K and B are variables, X and Y are the constant parameters in the equations. So, this solution set describes the parameters of all possible lines passing through the image points, namely P1 and P2. We call this representation as KB parameter space. Actually, we represent the parameter space with an accumulator array in practical computation. And it is a discrete representation of the KB parameter space. Thus, for each image point found in XY image space, a discrete line in the parameter space is drawn. This operation is performed additively so that values of the array through which the line passes are incremented by 1. The value at each cell of the accumulator array is the number of parameter space lines that intersect it. In our case, it's 2, since we have two pointers, P1 and P2 here. Namely, for each point on the lines in the XY image space, a line is drawn in the KB parameter space. This means that if n points lie on a line in XY image space, then n lines intersect at position KB in the KB parameter space. This is a very important concept of the Hough Transform. We are interested in the intersect point. However, in the normal KB representation, vertical lines pose a problem because K equal to infinite, namely the slope equal to infinite for vertical lines. The Hessian normal form avoids this problem by representing a line by its angle theta and a distance rho from the origin. So, we will use the theta rho parameter space in the code instead of KB parameter space. Please see this representation and the ranges of the theta angle and the distance rho from the origin. Another important concept is that if we use the center of the image as the reference point for the XY image space, then it is possible to limit the range of this radius, distance rho from the origin, namely max rho to half length of the diagonal of the image. This is the center point and this is the max rho. We will see this in the code later. Now let's start code again. Step 3. Define necessary variables and their ranges. Set the reference point in the XY image space first, namely the center point of the image. Thus, we can set the center of the image as the reference point for XY image space. This point. Size 0 divided by 2 to theta angle of the line in theta rho parameter space, namely half space. For half transform, the range of the theta angle is from 0 to 180. However, the step size can be defined properly. For example, we may define the step size of the theta angle freely. In this tutorial, we define the step size in the theta angle as 0.5 degrees. Actually, thus, the range of from 0 to 180 will be divided into 360 steps. 360 steps. Then convert it into radian, since we use it radian in the calculation. We need max theta as well. Max theta is equal to 360. Please note that step equal to 0.5 degrees. For 3, distance from the origin to the line, distance. Per Hessian normal form for representing line, this is the Hessian form of line. Possible maximum rho should be equal to the half length of the diagonal of the input image. Half length. Half length of the diagonal. This is a measure that if there is any line at or near the endpoints of the diagonals. This point, this, and this. If we use center of the image as the reference point for XY image space, then it is possible to limit the range of the rho to half length of the diagonal of the input image. This is very important. Input image. Promax, first calculate the distance from origin, then convert it to int, then calculate the diagonal. Diagonal. For, as we have seen above, rho range will be max rho equal to diagonal, and we need max brightness as well. Maximum pixel values. 5. Define an output result half accumulator array as max rho max theta. this is the output array. Output will be right here. Reshape, max row, max theta. Step 3, loop through the whole image, transform the lines or points from x, y image space to the theta row parameter space. This is our loop, loops through all images, all pixels of space. Actually, we use later max brightness. Only the white pixels. Max. Unit in radian. Since we are using XY image center as the reference point, we use this kind of expressions here. Center point. This is the raw from origin to the line. Distance from origin to the line. Get the raw distance. Origin to the line. Okay? Okay. In case, put some conditions here. Raw. Okay. In case, place some condition. Then this point will be incremented by 1. For each point on a line in XY image space, incremented by 1. This is very important. For example, if half AC equal to 50, that means that there is a line in the XY image space and that line consists of 50 pixels or points. Consists of 50 pixels or points. This is very important. Save and display the result. Fig size 12, 12, 10. Initial gray, set some title, original image, the result, display result. Initial half AC, gray, extent, this is the range. Set title, half transform. Set X label, set the angle, its range, and step size. Step size. Then set Y label, distance from the origin, namely rock, and its range. This is range. This is our code. Okay, now let's check it again. If I added a lot of comments, these comments will be help you understanding these codes. Okay. it seems to be okay. 2, okay, 4, okay, now it seems to be okay. We run it. We are waiting. We are still waiting. This is the result. Original image, result, half transform. Theta angle range and step size, raw angle range and step size. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 line. And there are also 11 points, white points. This is our, it seems to be great. This is our code, final code. You can find this code, a link just below the YouTube video. Thank you for your listening. Please subscribe. This is the result. Thank you.